Hello everyone, how are you guys doing today? My name is Harris and welcome back to my channel. So this is a second video for Norm Macdonald, and I thought was best way to start than his most savage moments. As I mentioned, I haven't seen any of Norm Macdonald's comedy stand-ups or anything. I've seen maybe one or two clips from Conan, that's about it. Everything else is actually brand new to me. And I am glad, because the first video I did, I really did like it. And I am going to be doing a lot more of it. It's only fair that I do Norm Macdonald for the whole week. So this is the second video for Norm Macdonald's most savage jokes. So without any delays, let's get to it. Here we go.
Well, it is finally official. Murder is legal in the state of California.
Why is it got O.J. picture at the back?
A down-and-out O.J. Simpson, depressed that all of his money-making ideas have failed, has decided to go back to doing what he does best, killing people. And there's Charles Woodson. How about that? And what a season he had. Great, Manny. He became the first defensive player to win the Heisman Trophy. And congratulations, Charles. That is something that no one can ever take away from you. Unless you kill your wife and a waiter, in which case...
Oh!
All bets are off. It's a word of advice. A new book claims that Madonna once smeared peanut butter all over John F. Kennedy Jr.'s body and then licked it off. Which just goes to show you, Madonna's a whore.
Such a simple joke! Such a
and
simple
finally,
joke!
Weekend Update would like to congratulate Madonna, who gave birth to a beautiful baby girl last Monday. The baby weighed in at 6 pounds, 9 ounces, making it the fourth largest object ever to pass through Madonna's birth canal.
Oh, God!
This week, in a secret ceremony in Australia, Michael Jackson was married for the second time. Asked what makes his new bride special, the King of Pop said, quote, "She has taught me about the power of imagination, like imagining that a grown woman is a 10-year-old boy."
Ah! Dude, the man is savage!
You
fuck
know he's
me!
A homosexual pedophile, right? You understand? Sources report that Michael Jackson's baby is due February 27th, and it's going to be named Michael Jackson Jr. Michael plans to be with the mother during the delivery, in his words, to make up for not being there for the Sources report that Michael Jackson's baby is due February 27th. It's conception. The last word was conception, so.
Michael Jackson?
Yeah? Did you mean to say Michael Jordan there, or do you want to say Michael Jackson?
Michael Jackson. He said, I heard a quote where he said, I don't care if my child is a boy or a girl, as long as it's a boy. He's going to name it. He said he doesn't know what he's going to name it. He said he thinks if it's a girl, he's going to name it Sharon.
Really?
Yeah. And if it's a boy, he's going to have sex with it.
That's a new
set. Safer drivers, men or women? Well, according to a new survey, 55% of adults feel that women are most responsible for minor fender benders, while 78% blame men for most fatal crashes. Please note that the percentages in these pie graphs do not add up to 100% because the math was done by a woman. For those of you hissing at that joke.
Oh my God. I had to stop this because I'm only 3 minutes in and this video is 15 minutes long. Oh my God. The man is savage. These are some brilliant jokes, especially OJ and Michael Jackson. And now this, I was gonna stop in the last one, but oh my God, this is so funny. Oh my God, it's so brilliant. I'm going to pause it once again when we get to just over past halfway. Let's call it 12 minutes or 10 minutes. I'll pause it at 10 minutes and we'll talk about more about that. But this is brilliant. Oh my God, I love that OJ joke. And he keep dragging on about Madonna as well. That birth joke for Madonna. Oh, that was brilliant. So let's get to it. Let's see what else he's got under his belt. Oh my God, he is savage.
It should be noted that that joke was written by a woman. So now you don't know what the hell to do. No, I'm just kidding. We don't hire women.
I came in and he was supposed to be the my guide through SNL. And it turned out that he is a shit stirrer.
I'm not going to guide any lady through comedy. That would take me, first of all, I'd have to figure out how a lady could do comedy. You know? And then I'd have to...
People often say to me, you know who the real heroes are? I go, are they the real heroes? They go, no. I go, oh, they're the teachers. It's counterintuitive that it doesn't seem like a heroic job, but yes.
This sound quality looks a bit better.
First of all, if you're a teacher, you get the same fun of vacations as a child. Like 4 months a year off. You know? My vacation? I get almost no time off. We're 48 weeks a year. Like 4 weeks a year I get off. What about you? You're not one of those fucking teachers, right? You seem like a teacher. Now, are you a teacher? What do you teach? What grade?
High school.
What grade? What grade? No, but what grade? Not so easy when it's the other way around. It's easy to ask the questions. The real heroes are the fucking students.
I'm finding it hard to understand, I think.
I actually have to answer the question. Now, what grade do you teach? 9 through 12. So you need a grade 13 education.
What did he say?
No, you're the real hero. No, I'm just kidding. You're the real hero. Our husband said, you're not the real hero. Shut the fuck up.
I'm kidding. You're the real hero.
You have a hero? Norman Fowler from Three's Company.
That's your hero?
Yeah. Mr. Roper. Yeah.
I know Mr. Roper?
Yeah.
That's not a good hero.
It's all I got.
Better than this guy's hero is some gay porn actor. Anyway.
What are you talking about? What?
I don't know.
Insane.
I don't know.
What are you saying?
Let me tell you something about gay porn.
What?
Seriously.
Yeah, there's nothing in it.
Okay, no, I'll tell you something about gay porn, seriously.
Okay.
That doesn't mean a guy's gay. I'm not saying that, because a guy watches gay porn all the time.
Did you cut to a single? Just ignore him, really?
Gay porn. I enjoy gay porn. I'm not gay. Gay porn is a genre that just cuts across all demographics. You know? Young people, old people, straight people, the gay people enjoy it. Everybody likes gay porn. But this guy really likes it. I don't know.
I'm getting music playing behind that speech.
No, that's not what I meant to say. I meant to talk about Bob Dole. This guy's my hero.
Ruined my reputation, you know.
I'll tell you
something. Passing.
This guy is not gay. If anybody's not gay, it's this guy.
I am so totally straight.
Oh, yeah. You are.
Oh, I love the ladies.
No, he does. No, he likes girls. He likes... Last week at a dramatic press conference about the crash of TWA Flight 800, ABC News correspondent Pierre Salinger displayed a document which he believes is proof that the jet was shot down
by a U.S. Navy missile. Later, he proudly showed reporters his solid gold Rolex that he bought on the street for just $15. That's one ugly bastard, isn't it? Here we see the president and the first bitch. Gosh, Hillary looks pretty in this photo here, doesn't she? Never realized she was such a looker till I see her here in this picture. Well, you see, the only way Bill Clinton or Bob Dole can win, really, is if Bill Clinton is rocked with more scandals. You know, yeah. There's every day a new scandal comes up. You know, I heard this one today, terrible scandal. Apparently, way back when he was governor of Arkansas, Bill Clinton apparently he got really drunk one night and he had sex with Hillary.
Wow. Yeah.
That picture, Jack?
Shocking thing.
Yeah. How long have you been married?
7 months.
7 months, which is a record.
I've been married, Larry. But I've never been married.
Married.
This is married.
Married like...
She's my friend. Like, I love her.
I see. That's what Clinton says about his wife, isn't it?
In Whitewater News, federal regulators quizzed Hillary Clinton at the White House this week and gave her a perfect score on the lying section. She's a dirty liar.
Of course, they say the White House is haunted. Did you know that? And I thought this was kind of sad. I heard last night that President Clinton charged Abraham Lincoln's ghost $10,000 to sleep in his own bed. So that doesn't seem right to me, you know? I mean... No. But look, the president, you know, has come under a lot of fire for raising money, but you know, he's good at raising money. That's not a bad thing. Every president's done it. It's just that President Clinton is very, very, very good at it. Do you know he has organized in the past year over 100 fundraising dinners and over 200 fundraising midnight snacks? Did you know that? Is he laughing?
Okay, Norm, you're Canadian.
Yes, I am.
So what do you think of this whole presidential mess?
I hope that the Democrats don't steal the election from the winner, you know, but who knows?
You like George Bush, don't you?
I love George Bush, man. He's a good man, decent, you know, none of this. He's not a liar, a crook, murderer, or anything like that. So it'd be good to get the. See, I think we should get the homicide out of the White House and get like a fresh start, because we don't want any more murderers.
I think we should just go on to the next question.
Oh. Who's
murderous?
Yeah. Oh, Clinton, he murdered a guy.
Yeah, you know, you're not allowed to put out accusations with that.
That's
one,
a little
Charlie.
Too far.
That's the way it does
let's
work.
Let's just go on to the next question.
Yeah.
This is not my week. What can I tell you?
Oh, it's not mine either, and I'm being very nice, okay? Be a good boy. Now, Norm.
Do you never hear that?
No. Listen, we don't need
I
to
don't
talk
get
about
into this.
This.
I don't want to
hear
it, and this
you
is not the place to
shit.
Make those accusations. And you're supposed to be funny. Let's get on with it.
Exactly.
So get with it.
There you go.
This is a live show.
Not
live.
Norm, but you have been properly chastised by Barbara. So I'm not going to ask the next question.
I thought it was a matter of record.
Shut up.
He's not letting that go.
Do this, okay?
I'll tell you what's a matter of record. You will not be invited back if you don't shut up. All right, now. Let's talk football.
All right, manslaughter.
Let's talk football.
Norm.
The people here asked me to do the show, you know, I got to say, I felt kind of weird, you know. I don't know if you remember this, but I used to actually be on this show.
That's enough.
I used to do the weekend update news routine. You remember that? And, that's where I did the make-believe news jokes, you know? That was me, right? So then, a year and a half ago, right, I had a sort of a disagreement with the management at the NBC. I wanted to keep my job, right? And they felt the exact opposite. So you see, they they fired me because they said that I wasn't funny, you know? Now, with most jobs, I could have had a hell of a lawsuit on my hands for that, but see, this is a comedy show. So they got me, you know what? But now, this is the weird part, right? It's only a year and a half later, and now they asked me to host the show. So I wondered, I go, hey, wait a second here. Hey! I go, how did I go in a year and a half from being not funny enough to be even allowed in the building to being so funny that I'm now hosting the show? How did I suddenly get so goddamn funny?
Yeah, you did.
It was inexplicable to me, because a year and a half, let's face it, is not enough time for a dude to learn how to be funny. Then it occurred to me, I haven't gotten funnier. The show has gotten really bad. Funny compared to, you'll see later. Okay, so let's recap. The bad news is, I'm still not funny. The good news is, the show blows. All right, folks, we got a bad show for you tonight. Dr. Dre, Snoop Doggy Dogg, and Eminem are here.
So, that was Norm Macdonald, most savage jokes. I mean, the beginning, like the moment I paused, I don't know why, at that point, I think he had one of the best jokes. Afterwards, that teacher joke, I don't know what it was about. I couldn't hear properly for some reason. If it has too much static noise in the background or something, so I don't know what that joke was. But overall, it was actually quite funny. Last joke, I really enjoyed that last one as well, when he's talking about being fired from the show and then being asked to come and host the show. But there were some very good jokes. I did enjoy quite a few of those. And some of them, I think, I don't know why, they just sort of felt flat to me. So, but overall, I'll say it was decent. I am looking forward to more of Norm Macdonald, as I mentioned. But I was going to pause in between again, but I decided against it because I was just emotional. I was just in a moment. I was enjoying the whole thing. It was funny. I enjoyed it. I think the savage moment was just the first 5 minutes of it. Afterward, it went down a bit. But that intends to happen occasionally because people don't realize the meaning of savage. Because the first five jokes, first 10 jokes he did about Madonna, Michael Jackson and OJ jokes were just absolute bang on. They were just brilliant jokes. They were funny to the point that, like, I was in stitches during that point, and afterward it just sort of fell a bit. But overall, it was good. I enjoyed it, and I hope you did too. If you did, like, subscribe, and share, and I'll see you in the next Norm Macdonald video.